welcome to all you Aries people. Welcome for your monthly forecast for Aries for the month of November 2014. What is happening for the Aries people? I'm always interested very, 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 very much to look at that because I have my moon in Aries. I relate. I understand what Aries people are going through. And so what is happening? What is mostly important with the, in general, of course, for you Aries people, but what are the planets doing? Well, there are three things quite interesting for you. First of all, there's a stellium in the sky, and I'll explain in a minute what that is. Secondly, Saturn is playing a huge role, which you're not keen on Saturn. I mean, people with planets in Aries, which is all about doing, impulsivity and doing and acting, and Saturn is about slow down. So Aries people mostly don't receive Saturn that well, but Saturn is playing a big role now, and only especially the two first weeks of the month, and then your ruler, what is happening with your ruler Mars. It's a shifting sign. So let's get started with stellium. Stellium, what is a stellium? It's three or more planets in the same sign. And it's all clustering, coming together in Scorpio, which is for you the eighth house. Again, a very dark house perceived by an Aries person because it's a water house. Water and fire. It's a bit of a paradox. It's a bit of a contradiction. Not paradox, but it's a bit different, let's say, to say the least. So the energy for you, especially the first 2 weeks, goes very much inwards because Scorpio is inner energy. It's energy. It's very. It's also ruled by the same ruler as your sign, so it's very active, but it's on the inside, and that's what you are not used to. So this energy has been there with Saturn there for quite a while. Saturn has been like 2 years in that Scorpio house teaching you its lessons about the slowing down of the process of the eighth house, about the transformation that all Aries people are going through that has to do with little or big anxieties, that has to do with strength, that has to do with trust, because that's the eighth house in a nutshell. It's more than that, but anyway. So it's not Saturn will be there for the last time. So that's the good news to you Aries people. It's not gonna last forever. It's the last month that Saturn is in this rather complex house. And Aries is in general not complex. It's very straightforward, it's very open, very honest, and the eighth house is a very hidden house. It's complex. It has a complexity. Now, that stellium means a lot of planets there in the eighth house are all going to pass Saturn. So Venus is going to go towards Saturn in Scorpio, and then the Sun is going towards Saturn also in Scorpio, and then Mercury is also going to hit Saturn into Scorpio. So that's why I say that it's going to be a very Saturnian month. But it's also the last month that Saturn is in that house. So it seems to me, for all of us, it's like those last pieces. But those last pieces, that is again needed a lot of energy and a lot of focus and commitment for us to take. Especially the first 2 weeks of the month. So for you, what does it mean? It means that you are mastering yourself. Saturn is about mastering. And what are you mastering? You're mastering, as I said, it could be fears. For some of you, it's about a fear, or a little fear, or a big fear. You're mastering that, and you're doing the last effort. And then you can let go, and it is released. You've gone through that, and you are one of the most courageous signs there is. So you will achieve a lot after this month. For others, it has to do with being interested in something, in the occult, or in something that is taboo, and to be the Sherlock Holmes and investing very deeply into it. And then you can go on because you still need to invest, you still need to know the depths of something. It can also be intimacy, that you work on towards intimacy, you work on showing your vulnerable, your most vulnerable you towards one significant person in your life, so that you are going through that stage. So you see those, that eight houses, lots of different things at the same time. So, but these are general horoscopes, so I try to give you some clues there. So for some people, it really means that they are wrestling with intimacy, wrestling with trust, having a bit of an issue with trust and overcoming it, especially at the end of the month and next month. And why overcoming it? By super focusing on it, by super hard working on it, by being super attached to it in order to then let go of it and release it. And that's the liberation, you could say. That's what your the fruits that you are gonna get after the Saturn transit. Everyone gets fruits when they have had a Saturn transit, and you can only do your best, you can only work as hard as you can, but it's work on a very inner level. So don't forget, it's not things that other people see that are happening with you. So it could mean on a relational level that you are learning now to be intimate with someone, and that you are learning that it's not only being vulnerable, but that gives you actually the strength, and so on and so on. So it is all doing that to become a stronger person. And you are already a strong person, but even Aries people do have some little fears there. So you as well, do your work with overcoming them, and it's a big, I mean, you don't have to think it's wow, but it is a huge reward if you sense that you are becoming a stronger person, because you've tackled some issues that weren't that easy for you. Maybe for another person it's a piece of cake, but for you it wasn't that easy. So It's a deep 2 weeks, you could say. But then the planets shift into Sagittarius, and Sagittarius is a fellow fire sign, and you will feel so much more uplifted. You will already feel that around the middle of the month. I think Venus is in Sagittarius. Is it around the 16th, 17th? It's going into your ninth house, which is wonderful. You will feel that you have a vision again, that you know where you're heading at. You feel that things are going faster. And if there is one thing that an Aries wants and desires, it's going fast. You know, it doesn't... That's why, as I just explained, that's why this period of time with Saturn there in the eighth house, and now especially those 2 weeks in November, has been not the easiest time. But it's there to give you that uplift again, and to understand that so as from the second part of November up until, you know, December as well, there will be this other focus to your ninth house, which is your vision, your belief. You will believe in things again. You will start working on that, because Saturn is then going to enter that house. But you see, there's a difference between starting something and ending something. So here it is the ending of a process of that eighth house, but there's, whilst that is still going on, there is already the universe or God, if you like, showing you where you're heading at, and showing you the energy of fire, which is spirit, which is enthusiasm, which is what your sign is really all about. So the last part is way more flamboyant, you could say, and you will thrive more there. But you know, so every now and then there are some times that we have affinity with, and others that we have to do a bit more hard work there. So that's the most important thing. I don't want to get too much into detail because it's already a lot. Oh yes, I almost forgot, your ruler Mars is shifting towards Capricorn. And that's your 10th house. That's the highest part of the horoscope. And so it's in Capricorn, and Mars is going to the whole month into that 10th house, and it's also going to aspect Pluto. So be aware of, don't fall into ego conflicts, especially at work, especially with bosses, especially with authorities, so people who wear uniforms. Don't let yourself fall into that trap of ego conflict. Be aware that, you know, respect their boundaries, but have your boundaries as well. It can also mean just a time as well that you are going to work hard, that you are going to put a lot of your effort, your energy into work. And if you do look for a new job, there is a lot of chances that you are getting that new job, because Mars is action and 10th house is work. So, thanks for listening. Have a good month, you Aries people, and see you next month. Have a good month.